Nice to have you with us.
Will you take me home, please, Mr. Ludden?
This week, we celebrate Richard Dawson's birthday, and I should know, I'm his son, Gary. My dad was born in a small town called Gosport, England, and joined the Merchant Navy at 14, where he started boxing. After the Navy, he took to the stage and soon was starring on the hit series Hogan's Heroes. After six seasons of the comedy POW, Dad joined the Match Game cast until he was offered a hosting gig on Mark Goodson's new show, Family Feud. My dad passed away in 2012, but he would have been so proud that Feud is still going strong. Happy birthday, Dad, from Buzzer and me.
Today on Family Feud, from Northridge, California, meet the Don't Try to Spell Me, Guglielmi family. From Pittsburgh, Massachusetts, they're bursting with energy and packed with power, it's the Dower family. You're about to see these two teams battle it out for $10,000 in cash, cause it's time to play the Family Feud.
Welcome to the Family Feud. It's the Guglielmi family. Wow, that's a weird name, isn't it? We'll get to that later, and the Dower family. But right now, let's play the feud. Come on. Welcome.
All right, good luck. We surveyed 100 people. Top 7 answers on the board. You got to try to find that most popular answer. Name something which might not exist, but people believe in anyway. Michelle.
Ghosts.
Ghosts. You believe in them?
My kids do.
Show me ghosts. There's two answers that can beat that, otherwise they're going to play.
I'm going to say Santa Claus.
Santa Claus. Santa. I always have to play Santa. All right, show me Santa Claus.
We're going to play.
All right, Donna, nice to meet you. How are you?
Yeah, good.
Introduce me to your family.
Well, this is my cousin, Jonathan.
Hi, Jonathan.
My sister, Doreen.
Hello. Hi.
Right there's my cousin, Diane.
Hi, Diane.
Hi, Louie.
And she would be the good twin sister at the end there, Deborah.
The good and bad twin sisters. Yeah. Hey, Jonathan, what do you do?
I'm a writer.
Writer. Oh, good. We'll write something for me. Right? All right. Name something which might not exist, but people believe in anyway.
Leprechauns.
Leprechauns.
Good answer. Good answer.
Let's see leprechauns. Is it up there? Show me leprechauns. Oh. One strike. On. Doreen.
Hi, Louie.
How are you? Well, we're safe with you.
I don't know about that.
All right. Name something which might not exist, but people believe in anyway.
How about the Easter Bunny?
The Easter Bunny.
Yeah. That's good.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Yeah.
Show me the Easter Bunny. Oh. Two strikes. Get ready. Hi, Diane.
Hi, Louie. My favorite comedian.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Give them 100 points. Why not? All right. So you're the good twin, or?
Evil sometimes.
Evil sometimes?
Good and bad.
All right. Aren't we all? Name something which might not exist, but people believe in anyway.
Tooth fairy.
Tooth fairy.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
How much did you used to get under the pillow? What was it?
Quarter.
Quarter, yeah. Mm-hmm. We were poor, we get a penny. I pulled 90 teeth the first year. Show me Tooth Fairy. Yeah. The other twin?
The good one.
The good twin. All right, Deborah, what do you think? You know,
okay.
Something which people might not, which might not exist, but the people believe in anyway.
Witches.
Witches.
Oh, good one.
Good answer. Yeah.
Good one.
That's good.
Show me witches. Oh. Oh, come on, give me an answer. It's your chance to share. There you go, get an answer.
Boogeyman.
I'm ready.
Boogeyman.
Boogeyman. Boogeyman! What? Boogeyman! Show me Boogeyman, otherwise they get the money. Show me Boogeyman!
Oh, they get the money!
All right, well, let's see the rest of it. Show me number one. UFO. Oh, yeah. Number four. God. What do you mean might exist? Number five. Loch Ness Monster. That's on tomorrow's show. That fit. Number seven. The devil. Ooh. Well, the end of round one has a score. The Dower's 33, the Guglielmi 0. But it's early. And remember, the family with the most points at the end of the game goes on to play Fast Money for $10,000. We're back round two. Right after this. Come back. Welcome back to Family Feud. We have the Dowers with 33 points. Woo! We have the Guglielmis with 0. Oh, but there's a lot of times. Let's meet the Guglielmis. Hi, Michelle.
Hello.
Nice to meet you. Introduce us to your family.
This is my father, Arthur.
Hey, Arthur.
Hi, Louie.
Next is my mother, Sandra.
Hi, Mom.
Hi.
How are you?
Next is my brother, Robert.
Hi, Robert.
Hello, Louie.
And last is my little sister, Tammy.
Tammy.
Hello.
Oh, you're so nice. You know what we should do right now?
Let's play.
Play the Feud.
All right. You got it. Come on. Go, Dad.
Woo! All right. Get over here now.
Okay.
We don't want you losing you on there. We surveyed 100 people. Top 5 answers on the board. You got to find that popular answer. Name something that annoys you when you go to the movies. Arthur.
Talking.
Good answer.
Very good answer.
Jabbering. You mean the people in back,
yeah?
Yeah, always. Show me talking.
Yeah!
We're gonna play. All right, let's do it. Hey, hi, Mom.
Hi.
How are you?
Fine.
Nice to see you.
Thank you.
All right, what annoys you when you go to the movies? Can you give me an answer?
Yes, when someone has to get up to go to the bathroom.
When someone has to get up to
go to the bathroom. Good answer. Very good.
Now, wait a minute. Now, more than if they stayed? No. All right. Show me people who get up and go to the bathroom. Oh. Not there. Hey, Robert. How are
Hello,
you?
Louie.
What do you do, Robert?
I'm a CPA.
Oh, good. Ooh, perfect. Oh, the books are good. Name something that annoys you when you go to the movies.
How about the long lines?
The long lines.
Good answer. Woo! Good answer,
Robert. Show me long lines. Two strikes.
Come on, Tammy. Keep
You're ready
going.
Over there. Tammy?
Yes.
How are you?
I'm good.
Good. What annoys you when you go to the movies?
How about loud chomping? The food behind you?
Good answer, Tammy. Very good.
Yeah. Loud chomping. Show me loud chomping.
Come on.
Yeah. Oh. It's there. What do we know? What do we know? All right. Michelle?
Ready?
I'm ready if you are. Name something that annoys you when you go to the movies.
How about children not minding in their seats?
Wow. Children not
good
minding
answer.
In their seats.
Very good answer. Good.
Show me children not minding in their seats.
Yeah.
Crying babies.
Come on, or keep it going.
The short version, crying babies. All right. What do you think, Arthur?
How about smoking?
Smoking.
Oh, good answer.
Oh, now that's two strikes. Get ready. You might be able to steal. Show me smoking. Come on, give me an answer. Come on. What do you think?
Give me some answers.
Kick it back in the seat.
Kick it back in the seat.
Sticky floors.
Okay.
Sticky floors. What do you think? Come on, I need an answer.
Kicking the back of the seat.
Kicking the back of the seat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, if you get it, you get the money. If you don't, they get the money. Show me kicking the seat. They get the money. All right. I thought that might be back there, too, but let's see the rest of the answers. Number three, gum on the floor. I think you had that, yeah. And number five, people's heads. We want a headless audience. All right, let's play again. Come on over. Let's play. We've got another question. All right, we got the Guglielmi's 83, and we got the Dower's 33. All right, ready for this next question?
No.
You're not, huh?
Yeah.
All right. All right, 10. Huh? All right, surveyed 100 people. Top three answers are on the board. Name a gift often given on Mother's Day. Doreen.
Flowers.
Good answer. Yeah.
Show me flowers.
Please show me flowers.
Number one. Yes. They're gonna play on Mother's Day. All right, evil twin.
Okay.
Diane.
Candy.
I think that could be given any day, actually. Show me candy.
Yes.
That surprises me.
Me too.
Yeah, well, it makes two of us. Hi, Deborah.
Hi. Okay, gift certificate.
Okay.
Good answer.
Sure, sure.
Good answer.
Show me gift certificate. Two strikes, come two on, strikes. Two strikes. Huddle, huddle.
Can we
come on, Donna.
Okay.
Save the show.
I don't get this right. My mother will kill me, right?
I suppose.
Well, you ready? Jeez. Jewelry.
Jewelry.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Come on. Show me jewelry, huh?
How about a card?
Yeah, I like that.
That's good. Show me card.
Yes!
They get the money. We'll be right back. We're going to triple the value and find out who's going to play Fast Money for a chance at $10,000. Don't go away. Welcome back to the Family Feud. The Dowers have 119. Woo-hoo! The Guglielmis have 83. Woo-hoo! Whoever is in the lead at the end of this question goes on to play Fast Money for a chance at $10,000.
Yeah!
Let's go. Let's play. Come on.
Here we go.
All right. Here we go. This is it. Can you have it up there? I'm just kidding. I don't know. I don't know what the rule is.
I don't either.
Well, that makes two of us. All right, point value's tripled. All right. And on this round, we've thrown a twist in. Were you ready for a twist?
Sure.
You only get one strike.
One.
Any wrong answer, you lose control. You got that now?
Got it.
Okay, here we go. Surveyed 100 people. Top three answers on the board. Come on, give me that most popular answer. Name a popular pizza topping. Robert.
Pepperoni.
Pepperoni.
Good answer. Good answer,
show me pepperoni. Number one. Pass or play.
What do you guys want to do? We're gonna play.
All right. Good luck.
All right.
All right. All right. Tally. Like pizza?
Love it.
Great food, isn't it? What's your favorite topping?
Myself or the answer?
The answer. That's what we need. Give us the answer.
How about sausage?
Yeah,
how
good
about
answer.
Sausage?
Very good answer.
Sausage? Show very me sausage. Good. Come on, show me sausage. Sorry, you lose it. We gotta go get a chance.
Yeah.
Somebody's gonna be the winner.
Cheese.
Cheese?
We're gonna go with cheese.
Cheese. All right. If you get it, you win. If you don't, they win. Somebody's gonna play for $10,000.
Oh my God.
Show me cheese. Yes! All right. Congratulations. Sorry, guys. But you have that great name, so that's good. Show me that last one. Mushrooms. Oh. Who's gonna play Fast Money?
I'm gonna meet my sister.
All right, who's gonna go first? Hey, come on, you go off there. All right, when we come back, we'll play Fast Money for $10,000 in cash. Come back. Welcome back to the Feud. Dower family won the game. Now, of course, we have Donna off stage where she can't hear.
Hopefully.
No, she can't. And she can't see it either. So we're going to ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. You'll try to give me the most popular answers. And if you can't think of something, say pass.
Okay.
And then we'll come back to it if there's time left. Get $5 a point for the answers. Or if you get 200 points, you get what?
$10,000.
All right. You ready?
I'm ready.
Give me 20 seconds on the clock, please. Now, the clock won't start until after I finish the first question, okay?
Okay.
All right. Good luck. Name a business that might be open 24 hours a day.
Grocery store.
Name something that gets better with age.
A wine.
Name a food people prefer to eat raw.
Sushi.
Okay. Name an occupation that requires a helmet.
Pass.
Name something you find in a courtroom.
A courtroom? Judge.
Name something that requires a helmet.
Motorcyclist.
Great. Yeah! All right. Let's see how you did, all right? Name a business that might be open 24 hours a day. You said? Grocery. I know I like it when they are.
Liquor.
Survey said? 35. All right. Name something that gets better with age. You said? Wine.
Fine wine.
You know that grocery store was the number one answer? Did you know that?
No, I didn't.
All right. Well, you do now.
I do now.
You said wine, the survey said? 45.
Ooh, she's got it tough.
Name a food people prefer to eat raw. You said sushi?
Sushi.
You said sushi, actually.
I did, sushi.
That's all right, that's the Canadian pronunciation.
I'm from New England.
Survey said? 2507, very good. All right. Name an occupation that requires a helmet. You said? Motorcyclist. Certainly, I've had. Survey said? 6. There were 6 hits. Name something you find in a courtroom. You said?
A judge.
Judge.
Survey said? 30. 143. 143. Donna, where's Donna? Donna. Where'd you go, Donna? You know what?
What?
Doreen got 143 points.
She's all right, huh?
That's all right. All right, you need 57 points to win, all right?
Okay.
I'm going to ask you the same 5 questions. You cannot duplicate the answer. If you do, you'll hear this sound. Ooh. You'll try it. You'll say, I'll say try again, and you'll give me another answer, right?
Okay.
All right. Now, first, let's remind, come on, I'm not going to hurt you.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Let's remind everyone. Yeah, that's all right.
Okay.
Remind everyone the answers that Doreen gave us. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Now, the time will start after I read the first question, okay? Name a business that might be open 24 hours.
A quick store.
Try again.
Pass.
Name something that gets better with age.
Your looks.
Name a food people prefer to eat raw.
Sushi.
Try again.
Carrots.
Name an occupation that requires a helmet.
Football.
Name something you find in a courtroom.
The judge.
Try again.
Lawyer.
Name a business that might be open for 24 hours a day.
Fast food.
Got it?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, okay.
Very good. Very good. Very good.
All right, let's see how you did. Name a business that might be open 24 hours a day. You said fast food. Survey said.
Okay.
Of course, as we said, grocery store is number one. Name something that gets better with age. You said looks. I hope you're right. Survey said.
Oh.
Zero. Wine, number one answer. Okay. Name a food people prefer to eat raw. You said, what's up, Doc? You said carrots. Survey said?
20. Yeah.
20 points. You need 20 points? 20 points for $10,000. All right. Name an occupation that requires a helmet. You said football. If there's more than 20 points, you guys win $10,000. Survey said. Oh. Name something you find in a courtroom. You said lawyers. Now, lawyers, your whole thing relies on lawyers.
I know, is that pathetic?
You can never say another bad thing about lawyers if they get this. The survey said you need 5 points. Yeah!